How far would you travel for unconditional love? All forms of love, friendship, family, and romance. Discovering how we love all around the world to love you, love me, and love we. A few years ago, I started a mission to discover the meaning of love. Not just romance, all forms of love, friendship, family, and agape or unconditional love. So I put my years of media experience to use, and I started a show on Facebook called Amar Action. The intention of that show was to actively explore love. In a world full of apathy, I wanted to start a real conversation about love. Then I got a few calls from some famous friends out in Hollywood, urging me to bring this show out west. And after some thought, I packed up my New York City apartment and I booked a flight on JetBlue and took off to Hollywood, California.
Well, I went to Hollywood, California to, at the urging of my friends who, I have so many friends in entertainment, and I was just pretty much the last person left here in New York City. Everybody moved over to Los Angeles and they said, Amar, you have this show, come on out and, you know, let's see if you can do it out there. And when I got to Los Angeles, I started production right away.
Los Angeles, California.
Also, a key component to this show is discovering how love expresses itself all around the world. I'm so happy to be here in Los Angeles, California. Behind me is a Hollywood sign. This place means so much to the world. It's a place where dreams come true. It's a place where
The show was called Amar Action, is what I started here in New York City. The intention of the show was to bring action into love. My name means love. Amar means love in Spanish. So the intention was to bring love, to bring action into love, because really, what is love without action?
So I'm here at the Griffith Observatory to meet A.Jade Smith from Finding Cupid.
We invited one of our first guests, A.Jade Smith, to be on the Amar Action Show to talk about spirituality and something she called the shift.
Is the place where all your dreams come true. You said that everyone comes together.
I said, I feel like Hollywood is the place where all of our dreams are just up there. They're up there, they're in the sky, and then they just come down. And everyone's dreams are up there, and they're just waiting to pluck. We're just waiting to pluck our dreams from the sky.
So it's happening here for you.
It's happening here slowly, but it's not happening the way I thought it would happen.
Yeah, that's always
and that's the
case.
Beauty of life, is just things happen in a way that you didn't anticipate. We always have, I remember this quote, if you ever want to make God laugh, make plans. And it's true. And it's so true.
Yeah.
Because the plan will never be as you expected it to be.
Yeah.
Then, one day, A.Jade Smith invited me to be on a global talk show, Finding Cupid, with David Cruz of the Bravo TV series Millionaire Matchmaker.
I was asked to be on a show to talk about the filmmaking I've been doing, the show, the projects we were doing.
The show was a huge success. The conversations about love were flowing. And while at the studios, I was offered an opportunity to host my own show with two lovely ladies as my co-host. One of them, a dear old friend.
Coming up, the love begins in Hollywood.
Being at the studios, some of our neighbors was Judge Judy, Matt B, Kathy Griffith.
And a slumdog millionaire gives wisdom. As the Love We World Tour continues, back in a moment.
People say Californians are out there.
Oh,
know, we're out there. We're into some wild stuff. Woo!
Real wild. Like we're from another planet.
From another world.
We've got some far out ideas.
Far out!
And different tastes.
We may be out there.
But out there
is a pretty great place.
So join us.
You know where we'll be.
Start your trip at visitcalifornia.com.au.
So much to do tomorrow. I need to wake up early.
I'm so tired, but I can't fall asleep.
If I don't fall asleep,
I
sleep through my alarm,
so
my mind is spinning.
I feel so out of control.
70 million Americans can't sleep. Are you one of them? Dream water. The first water that helps you relax and fall asleep. Visit drinkdreamwater.com. Or these fine retailers to get your good night's sleep.
There is an indefinable, mysterious power that pervades everything. I feel it, though I do not see it. It is this unseen power which makes itself felt and yet defies all proof, because it is so unlike all that I perceive through my senses.
Over 2 years ago, I started a mission to discover what love really is. All forms of love, beyond romance, beyond friendship, and beyond family. So I started a show in New York City called Amar Action to answer those questions. Then I got calls from a few well-known friends out in Hollywood, so I decided to pack up my New York City apartment and bring the show out west.
Welcome to Amar Action. My name
During
is
the production of that show out on set and on location, we...
After being featured on the talk show Finding Cupid, I felt the conversations about love were finally beginning to flow. And apparently I wasn't the only one seeking to explore love, because a few days later, a producer at Sunset Bronson Studios in Hollywood offered me my own show as a host, digging deeper into the questions about love and spirituality.
I was offered a show at Sunset Bronson Studios to do a full-time talk show at Sunset Bronson Studios, filming with two other co-host, Tarsha, Vega, a very good friend of mine, and A.Jade Smith. So it was great. I mean, you know, it took all of 6 months for me to get settled, to get in to Los Angeles, get into Hollywood, to get a show, and it was an amazing thing.
With co-host A.Jade Smith and a childhood friend, Tarsha Vega, the chemistry between us all felt right.
Being at the studios, some of our neighbors was Judge Judy, Mad TV, Kathy Griffith is now at these studios. Let's Make a Deal, some major shows. I did some research also on this studio. In Facts of Life used to be filmed there, Golden Girls. So these studios were actually the old Warner Brothers set, So you walk into the studios and you see all this old Hollywood royalty all over the walls. Betty Davis, Joan Crawford. So it was really an amazing energy just being there at the studios.
Talking to guest after guest on this new show, I quickly realized that everybody wanted to talk about love, unconditional love. One of our first guests, Anil Kappor of Mission Impossible, and the Academy Award-winning film, Slumdog Millionaire, he came in one day and expressed ideas of spirituality beyond my limited Western comprehension.
So I got a chance to interview Anil, and Anil was just amazing. And his ancestry is that of East Indian. So we talked about a lot of spiritual things in the sense of Hindu and East Indian beliefs and everything. And during those interviews with Anil, I started to wake up and realize that the topic of love is something that no matter who you are, no matter where you come from, everybody really wants to talk about love. Love is like one of the most powerful things in our universe. And it's also one of the most mysterious things in our universe.
It was then I realized this was a conversation we needed to have throughout the world. but I knew that love was deeper and more expansive, and I began to realize our modern concepts of love felt conditional.
One of the things I always talk about in this show is conditional love. I am very sensitive to relationships with people. I sense that a lot of relationships are based on conditions, and maybe I'm a little bit idealistic, but I feel that our relationships should be unconditional. I think that love truly is unconditional, and marriages are conditional, friendships are conditional. It's really based on what can you give me, what do you have to give me, and sometimes family can be. The intention of this show is to show others that how we can use our relationships to reach a level of unconditional love, which is agape love. And agape love is the most powerful, strongest love in the world. I mean, you can liken it to God. Agape, God, unconditional, is all the same.
The stage was set, the show a hit. I left New York City after starting a small show on Facebook, and now here I was in Hollywood, California at a major studio talking to celebrities about self-awareness and spirituality. Yet, with all this success, I felt limited. Something was missing. There was more to explore about loving ourselves and loving others, and the way the world expresses love. So one night, after reading some Buddhist principles, at 3 a.m. in the morning with $2,000 of my rent money and a small HD camera, I called a friend and drove out to the neon lights of Las Vegas. I had a question on my mind that needed exploration about desire and suffering. It was unpredictable, unplanned, also unappreciated by the producers and the co-stars at the studios.
Coming up, Amar goes to Vegas to discover desire. Plus, an awkward moment at the studios.
Looked at the contracts and smiled, and everyone looked at each other very awkwardly in the room, and nothing else was said about it.
As the Love We World Tour continues, back in a moment.
The Mansfield Hotel?
Just so you know, I'll need another $25 for the bag in the trunk.
No, you don't.
No. Don't give me that.
A what?
Well, it's a new policy.
Why would you charge $25 to put a bag in the trunk of a cab?
You know, carry-ons are free, but when you put it in the trunk... Maybe it is a misunderstanding.
There's no misunderstanding.
No,
what you're trying to do is you're trying to jack up the fare.
Don't try to BS me.
Now you're trying to charge me some fare.
No, so apart from the fare, we pay $25 extra?
Wow.
The gas prices are high, like it was $4 before. Now it's different, but I don't have the policy.
I don't have time for this.
No. This is not right. I feel cheated.
I want to out of your cab.
Open the trunk. We're out of here.
Are you tired of check cashing fees? Bounce checks and overdraft fees driving you crazy? Introducing the AccountNow prepaid Visa card. AccountNow provides the perfect alternative to a checking account without the hassles and hidden overdraft or bounce check fees.
Before I found AccountNow, payday was a major hassle.
With AccountNow, I don't have to worry about overdraft fees.
With 100% approval and no credit check, get the fresh start you deserve.
Get your card now and receive $10 when you use the referral code LOVEWE.
This is John Darrell with an important message for you. What is love? Is love something you feel? Is love something you do? Or is love something that you are? Join Love We World Tour as we travel all around the world to discover the power of love.
At After starting a successful show at Sunset Bronson Studios in Hollywood, California, about self-improvement and spirituality, I began to look deeper into the meaning of unconditional love. So on a hunch, I drove out to Las Vegas to film a show on desire and suffering.
This building reminds me of the World Trade Center, actually. See that? This reminds me of the Twin Towers, and, you know, this place is really wonderful. I want to say that, you know, the message that I had today on today's show was about doing what you want to do. And just watching this building right here, these two buildings, it reminds me of all the people that lost their lives on September 11th. A day that I was there and I saw the horrific things that happened in 9/11. But don't wait, because you never know. Life is short. We're not promised tomorrow. So
the need to go out to talk to people began to feel like a new direction for the questions of love.
I didn't plan it. It wasn't planned. It was something that just was spontaneous. I just took $2,000 that I had, and I took a crew, a small crew, and a camera, and we just went to Vegas. And the reason why we went to Vegas is because I really wanted to find out something I had learned, a Buddhist principle that I had learned. It was called desire and suffering. So I saw what was happening with people. I saw the energy of people wanting to talk about love in Vegas. I didn't tell anybody at the studios that I was doing this. I didn't get permission. I just did it. I just followed my heart. And not everybody was pleased. Not everybody was pleased at the studios. My co-hosts were a little angry at me because I didn't tell them. I wanted to be spontaneous. I actually called into the show thinking that I was going to give them an element of surprise to just call in and say, hey, this is what I'm doing, but it wasn't very well received, nor was the topic well received. The whole topic of desire and suffering was a little bit confusing for the audience. So although I had great success and I felt very motivated, and I said, well, this is like a launch of something huge, I had some failures, and I realized that my work was pretty much cut out for me, because what I'm talking about is not what everyone is talking about. It's not what we're talking about in the mainstream media. So it's going to take some more discipline and more respect to the topic and more training on my part to go out and to talk on the road.
During this time, the principals at the studios offered a contract for the show. A decision had to be made.
I was given a contract. I was given a contract at these Hollywood studios, and I didn't sign it. I just didn't sign the contracts. I didn't say yes, I didn't say no. I just sort of looked at the contracts and smiled, and everyone looked at each other very awkwardly in the room, and nothing else was said about it. And the reason why, in retrospect, the reason why is because I just had a feeling that Love We World Tour was like a child for me. I didn't know what this child was gonna be. I was being very humble to what the intention of Love We is. I really didn't know what it was at the time. But one thing I did know is that it wasn't sitting in just one place. It wasn't talking to one group of people. It wasn't a traditional studio show. It was something where we're gonna go out into the world and travel. And there's a lot of parents out there, you know, listening. You know that you don't know what your child is gonna be. It might be a lawyer, a doctor, maybe the president of the United States, who knows? But you feel protective over that child so that they can realize what their mission is. And that's how I felt with Love We. So I didn't sign the contract.
So with a contract and a show hanging in the balance, I had to make a choice. Stay and develop a Hollywood-based show or follow this new direction.
So from there, I just got the idea to just go on tour. Go on tour because, I don't know, I just felt that I needed to go out into the world to travel, to talk to people about love. It wasn't enough being at a studio, a major studio nonetheless, but it wasn't enough just sitting in a studio and having people come through the gates of the studio and interviewing them. I knew I had a calling to go out into the world and talk to people.
I decided to follow my instincts and create a tour show about discovering all forms of love all around the world. named Love We World Tour. So I gave my keys to my Los Angeles bungalow to Tom Hardy's personal trainer, PNUT, who was filming the new Batman movie at the time. I packed up my car and I hit the road.
I love you, man.
To go out on tour all around the world, you have something to say. Hashtag the love and be sure to catch Love We this May. So with this new mission, Love We World Tour will discover all forms of love all around the world. Cultures, different beliefs, traditions, religions, people have their own way of expressing love. And I wanted the cameras to capture the world, starting here in the United States. I took my own money and I began to journey across the country. This was Love We though, not Love You or Love Me. This was Love We. So I found it necessary to get others involved. So broadcasting via Facebook and Twitter, I told others of this journey.
World on our Love Tour.
Someone came up with a great idea to pledge $1 a mile to get the tour on the road and in the air.
We Love We is about this mission to discover all forms of love all around the world. Not everybody wants to be loved the same way. We don't all want to be loved the same way. And we're discovering how you really want to be loved. What form of love suits you? Maybe it's friendship, maybe it's family. And how do we love based on our culture, based on our history, based on our backgrounds, our traditions? You know, it's a topic that will just keep going and going because love is one of the most mysterious things on the planet. What's more important than love in our lives? You know, when you're on your deathbed, you're not gonna think about how much money you made or how many clothes you had or how many shoes you had in your closet. You're gonna think, was I loved? And did I love others? Did I love others? Did you give love and did you receive love? We all want the same thing, to love. But we all want to be loved in our own unique way. So that's what this whole mission is about, discovering love all around the world.
Then, as we crossed the country, I sent out little updates from each city. And to add some fun to the journey, viewers would have to guess where I was in a segment called Where's Amar?
With another update about where I am, where's Amar? So, you guys have guessed it. Some of you guys tried to guess it.
But what was ahead for this tour? What was the purpose? We gathered some footage, but the idea itself still wasn't fully developed. I became very discouraged, and I even considered turning back and going back to Los Angeles.
Follow me. You gotta guess where I am next time. I'm not gonna make it easy for you next time. It's gonna get harder and harder. And keep giving me those addresses. I will send you postcards as to where I'm at in the United States. So, I love you. I love me. And I'm going to bed. Good night.
And then, worse comes to worse. I made a wrong turn down a long, snowy interstate. And the sporty Los Angeles car got stuck in the snow. This was not very good, very discouraging.
One thing I know for sure, music is the language of love.
My name is Haley L. Howell. I'm a singer and songwriter of an upcoming album, The Singing Angel.
I feel that my songs divinely come through me to help heal people who are hurting and are in need of comfort.
Sweet child, dry those tears. My love is wrapped around you. Have no fear.
When someone is missing a loved one who has passed on, they are not really gone. They are always with us in our hearts.
'Cause I'm not gone, I'm in your heart. Can you feel the softness of my wings? Close your eyes. Take my hand and understand, love never dies.
I want my listeners to feel that that is the true message of my song, love. That love never ends, it never dies.
Welcome, Haley Howell, to the Lovely World Tour.
Lovely World Tour became a mission to discover all forms of love all around the world. I felt compelled to go out on tour after being featured in a Hollywood studio hosting a show on self-awareness and spirituality. And although I had been involved in media and entertainment, marketing and advertising from behind the scenes most of my career, I never considered being in front of the camera until I had this need to discover unconditional love.
I pretty much got my start in this business reluctantly through a friend of mine, a very good friend of mine, Lana Moore. Lana Moore, you know her as MC Lyte. MC Lyte is hip hop royalty, the queen of hip hop. And Lana and I became friends when I was very young, I was 16 years old. Lana and I started a modeling agency together called Suave Talent Management. And through this venture, I just met everybody. And I was thrown in front of the camera because I was sort of the administrator in this business. But a lot of times models wouldn't show up and they would say, hey, you just throw some makeup on, put this jacket on and get in front of the camera. You know what? Honestly, the honest truth is that out of all this exposure I had to this business, I never seriously once thought of doing this, being in front of the camera and talking about anything. I never seriously thought about doing this until I got this vision, this feeling to talk about love.
As I sat in the car, stuck in the snow, I started to remember the strength and the courage of all my friends and how they pushed through in their own careers to deliver their own message of love.
Now Dana is very interesting. Dana, again, I don't call them by their stage names. Dana is Queen Latifah, Dana Owens. Dana, we were sitting around the table one day at Pizzeria Uno in the Village. And Dana once said, at this time Dana was huge. She was, you know, UNITY. And she said, look, I'm not done. I want to take this to the next level. I have a message I want to deliver to the world. I want to be a great actress and I want to be A-list Hollywood. And we're all like, yeah, right, sure, Dana. And she said to us, she said, you know what you do? You just do it. You just go in there, you kick the door down, you say, I have a script, I'm in it, let's do it. And Dana really has been an inspiration to me because look what Dana has achieved, you know? If it wasn't for my friends like Dana and Lana, who have showed me the rope in their own way, how to navigate through this business, I don't think I would be doing it. They are really doing it from a place of love. You know, you gotta do this from love because this is hard work. But they have a message to deliver, and that's what I love about them. They're delivering that message in their own way.
Then, a small snowmobile came up to the car. It was a gentle, soft-spoken man who dug the car out without any questions. The wrong turn I made was at Cove Fort in Utah, a fort built to protect settlers during the migrations of Mormons to Utah. Elder Luke welcomed me in and gave me a grand tour of the fort.
A telegraph office.
He spoke about his own beliefs, his own heartache, his own love, and he shared with me the history of his church.
2 years ago, my wife had cancer, stomach cancer, and we didn't know she was going to live or die. But we could be, are comforted in the fact that we know that we'll be together in the next life.
So this has to be one of the most amazing wrong turns I've ever made on this Love Week tour. I didn't intend to do this, but one thing that Elder Luke told us, and it touched me so much, is that this fort was made to protect people, and it did its job. It did just what it was intended to do, but it did it in peace. And it did it in peace and love. And that's what Love Week's all about. I'm sorry, I don't have any tissues, but that's what Love Week's about. So it's all about love. Love Week.
Love Week World Tour had a show. It was all about service. The tour had direction and purpose. Love Week World Tour was on the air.